Hello everyone, I am Jack from Jack's Reading Corner. And so, I thought, I'm gonna film one more video, and then I probably gotta go, because it's already 5:30, and I also have to charge my laptop. I have to plug it in, so I'm gonna film this one more quick video. It's time, Fantasy Fawn, created by Maddie from Book Pusher, is coming up, and I thought I would share with you my non-TBR, because I haven't got it together yet, but the books I'm thinking about, I'm just going to real quick go through them and share with you. Well, first let me present to you, Fantasy of the Dawn is April 5th through the 15th. Of course, fantasy books take a little bit longer to read. Wait, I got one more. Just a bit longer to read, so it's gonna be, I think, 10-day book-a-thon, read-a-thon. And of course, like any readathon, there's these challenges. Let's see if I can remember them. First of all, one of the challenges is to read a diverse book. Another challenge is to read the first book or a book. Or just whatever book you need to read in a series. Or another challenge is to read either the debut book, an author's debut, or a backlist book. I think. What I'll probably do is give the actual, write down the actual challenges. And then You have the challenge, the last one being you immerse yourself in the fantasy book you're reading, like either you make food that you talk about in the book, or, you know, maybe read while you're dressed up as the character, or, you know, something has to do with that world. And then, I can't remember the other challenge. Like I said, I promise to put the challenges in the video, like, put them in the drop box below. But, so there are a lot of books that I need to read first of all, like, for one of the books I'm thinking about for the diverse reading part is either this one, The Fifth Season, by N.K. Jemisin. So I think for diversity, they think it can either be a character that's diverse, or maybe, I don't know if it's, you might be able to pick an author that's diverse and written by, like, a diverse author or something. I don't know. Like I said, I will find the announcement video and post the challenge and write out the challenges. But I don't know much. I don't remember much about this. But I have been wanting to read this for a while, and I do know there is a part in the book that goes into second person, and a lot of people felt like that was a bit of a. That was something that people struggled with. And then there's also another possibility is, let's see if I can get it without messing up. Oh, there's Nevernight. I'm just looking for Nevernight. I remember another challenge. Is also read a book that you've temporarily DNF'd, but you are planning on coming back. Not permanently DNF'd, but one that you were going to come back to. And one of those for me is either Nevernight or Malice. I've started both these books, and they're also both books in a series. This is the first book in a series, and this is a trilogy, so I gotta finish that once I read a little bit of that today, as I talked about my video about what's going on with my reading today. And then one of the other diverse books that I'm thinking about is, because it's a book that I've never read about these type of characters, but Orcs. I need to get back into reading this one, and I feel like in a way this is diverse because you mostly read books about either elves, vampires, or werewolves. Or Fae. You don't read a lot of books about the characters like the orcs. And I also have another one here. Dwarves. both these characters, I feel like there's diversity because it is a little different. You don't, like I said, I don't read books about these characters or even watch movies where these type of characters are the central characters. These characters are usually, like, the orcs are a lot of times are the lackeys for the bad guys, and the dwarves are kind of the lackey, not necessarily the lackeys, but just, you know, they work with the main humans or the main elves or something. So I feel like that could kind of count as a diverse book. And then, a lot of these also are just books that are in the series or books I need to finish. But they're all fantasy, like I need to get back into Clash of Kings. This is the second book. This is my second go-around in reading the first three books of Game of Song of Ice and Fire series, so I need to get back into this one. And then I've been meaning to start this series because this is Elliot Brooks was doing a read-along of this one and some Brandon Sanderson books, his Cosmere Universe. And I think, you know, and they're on Blood of Elves currently. They will be, that, like, April is going to be that one, but it's kind of too late. You know, I mean, I guess I could just skip ahead, but I want to read these kind of in order. And technically, even though they say Blood of Elves is the first book, you know, this one and Sword of Destiny are kind of the first two books. I also need to get back into this one, and this is kind of diverse because it's about gods and stuff like that, and I don't read a lot of books, so it's diverse for me. Although it's probably not diverse enough, but either way, it's a fantasy book that I need to get back into and finish. And, like, the rest of a lot of these are also books that I've been meaning to read that in the fantasy department. The Wise Man's Fear by Patrick Rothfuss, the second book in the Kingkillers Chronicles, I've been meaning to get to this one. I've been meaning to get to The Lost Queen. This one I bought at the country bookstore. I haven't been to read this one for a while, and this is kind of one that says, like, the brother of our main character is kind of the inspiration for Merlin. And I believe this is the first book in the series. And I don't know if it might be the debut. But it's kind of described as Camelot or The Mist of Avalon meets Outlander. So I'm wanting to read that one. So that one I might read for the them. And now that I finally finished Mistborn, I can get to some of Brandon Sanderson's other books. So, The Way of Kings. This is a big chunker one. One of his big series. So I've been meaning to get to this one for a while, and I might bring this one on the cruise, maybe bring this one to my sister's place, I don't know. And then there's also, Elliot Brooks actually did a one-star review video where basically she reads funny one-star reviews of some of her favorite books, and this was the latest one that she read, and so I thought about this one as well. And this one has a very unique magic system. And Brandon Sanderson tends to take tropes and do a unique spin on them. So, in a way, that could represent diversity, too. And then, let's see, what else? And then, I also need to get into these two are books in a series. The first one, I started this one. And this one is a little unique because the characters are a little different and the magic isn't as, it's hard to explain, but, like, it's not as easy as how it is in YA, for characters in YA books. And it's a little more realistic if we really did have magic in the world and how it really would be. And I did watch the TV series, this is Magicians, by the way. And finally, I decided to buy the trilogy. So, this is the first one, as you can see, I did start it a while back. So I want to get, that's another one I've been wanting to read. Like I said, this is basically books I'm thinking about for the readathon. And then this other one that I need to start the series, it's a young adult book. And I do believe one of the challenges is also to read something that you're not used to in fantasy. Like, if you're not used to, if you don't read middle grade for this challenge. Or if there are certain types of fantasy that you're not used to, read those. But yeah, I've been meaning to get to this one, especially now that I finally have the whole series. And then, of course, there's this, the Temeraire series. I got the first three books. Which is basically if dragons were in the Napoleonic War. That's, like, pretty much what this is about. So, this is one I've been wanting to read. I've also been wanting to read more dragon books, especially adult dragon books. Like, I've read some middle grade ones, but I feel like I haven't read, like, enough adult ones. And I want to read more adult ones. And then I gotta get back into this, The Lies of Locmora. Now, this one, I don't know how much magic and fantasy is really in this. It's considered a fantasy, so I'm assuming there's some in there. It's like this guy Locke, and it's his life story as a thief. And he goes on, and there's a heist. He goes on, so I think it's like been compared to, Six of Crows. And some people even say it's a better version of Six of Crows. So, and I think this is his, it's a debut. It's a debut book, so. So that can be counted as my debut. And then, this is another one I've started. A while back, like last year, I guess. Jonathan Strange and Mr. Normal, I won by Susanna Clarke. I've been wanting to get back into this one, which is about two competing magicians who, this is like if magic was in the 19th century, and it's like this guy has been exposed as a magician, and so it's him and this, he's an older guy, and then this young magician and him are kind of competing, you know, because they have a different way of looking at it and how they should treat magic. So this is one, and I think it's a standalone. So I guess in a way I could do, because I'm so used to reading fantasy books that are series, so this could be, you know, in a way, you know, if I'm not, this, in a way, kind of meets one of the challenges too, in a way that it's a fantasy that I'm not necessarily used to reading because it's a standalone. So that could count for that, and if I wanted to. And then this one, The Carnival of the Dead, this one I'm actually not sure if it's a fantasy or not. It might not be a fantasy. But, like, this young woman finds that her sister has vanished in Venice on the night of this famous carnival, and Teresa, our main character, is going to find her. So it's like Caraval, I guess. It kind of reminds me of Caraval in a way. But maybe it's a more mature version of it, I don't know. But, I don't know if it will be included, if it has fantasy or not, but I'm going to find out. And this one might be one of the ones I might read. And, like, I don't read a lot of adult fantasy. I'm just kind of getting into it. So that might be, you know, in a way that's another something, you know, an out-of-the-box kind of situation. And then this one, I need to get back into it. But to be fair, this is two or three novellas in one big volume. So it's kind of okay that I've taken this big break in between the reading of these novellas. But Theft of Swords, the Rhaerya Chronicle of Revelations. And it's basically these two thieves, Royce and Hadrian, kind of get, they get, there are thieves for hire, and they get hired to steal the sword. But when they steal the sword, they get framed for the murder of the king. And the sister releases them. The prince is the king's daughter. The princess releases them and has them kidnap her brother, the prince, and sends them to this, on this mission to free this, get answers from the prisoner, and they end up setting him free, and there's this war for power. So I'm guessing them setting this guy free, this particular prisoner, is gonna come into play in the second book. So, and I'm really enjoying this. It's just so fun. I love both Hadrian Royce's characters. And I can't wait to read more, so this one I might read as well. And then the last book that I'm going to mention that I might read for this readathon is Kings of Wild. This is one that Jess Reads Books has talked about quite a bit. She absolutely loves this one. It's a group of, a band of mercenaries, and they've been friends since they were young men, but then now they're kind of retired age. And then one of them, his daughter gets kidnapped, so the band has to get back together and rescue this guy's daughter. And that's basically what it's about. So I have really been wanting to read this, but I've been kind of delaying it because I feel like I have so many other books that I've been meaning to get to, so I don't want to read this new book that I just bought. Well, I didn't just buy it, I bought it like months ago, but I don't want to read it over the books I've had for a long time, so. Which is part of my problem with consumerism and everything. But anyway, so those are the books I'm thinking about reading for the Fantasy-thon. Like I said, this is a readathon hosted by Missy from the Book Pusher. Maddie from the Book Pusher. And is also co-hosted by Julie from Pages and Pens. And there is another co-host that I haven't subscribed to yet. I've been meaning to subscribe to her since Maddie mentioned her on the announcement video. Like I said, I will list the challenges in the little drop box below when I upload this video. And if you guys like this video and want to, you know, be sure to give a thumbs up, I will post the announcement video in the I will also post the announcement video so that, you know, if you guys are interested in participating in this readathon, you still have a few days. And, please subscribe to my channel if you are interested, and I hope you are enjoying your reading, and I will talk to you later. Alright, bye!